Hi everyone, thank you so much for joining us for another monthly webinar. We have a really great webinar set up for you today. We're bringing in a special guest from Dominion Energy. So we're going to start out just as a reminder, our Ready Fairfax program is our preparedness program where we educate residents on how to prepare for, respond to, and recover from emergencies. Our monthly themes in 2024 is partnership preparedness through partnerships. So we're going to be bringing on a lot of different partners in 2024 that are going to talk about the different aspects of preparedness and what they do from their agencies and organizations. So it'll be a really great series. So without further ado, I am going to introduce Josh. He is from Dominion Energy, and he is going to talk to us all about what happens when the power goes out. So we're doing this one early in 2024 so that we can all be prepared and ready when those thunderstorms start rolling in.
Hey, good evening, everyone. Thank you for the introduction, Courtney. Again, I'm Josh Crawford, working the Electric Distribution Emergency Preparedness Center at Dominion Energy. I've been with the company for 8 years, primarily all in this role. So my primary focus for the last 8 years been storm restoration, outage management. So hopefully we have a good presentation for you all this evening. Just a high level agenda of what I'm going to go over. I'm going to start with an overview of power delivery, which is distribution transmission systems, emergency preparedness center, and the system storm center. I'll also discuss our external emergency preparedness partnerships and give you all a high level overview of storm restoration. And then we're going to close with customer communications. But keeping with a common trend at Dominion Energy, safety is our number one core value. So we always start any meeting that we have off with the safety moment. So I really want to just touch on the importance of safety during what we call bluebird days or your normal weather days, and then also in restoration events. A lot of times our corporate communications, external communications teams, they're sharing safety tips, storm restoration tips with our media partners and on social media and with the jurisdictions that we serve. And we're also, during major restoration events, we're sending out notifications to those customers who may have medical needs and who rely on electricity for their medical equipment at home. So before we get into one of those restoration events, one of those weather events, we want to share that information with those customers who are at increased need. So we have our communications team contact them and let them know that we are going to experience inclement weather, and please go ahead and start looking into making necessary accommodations in the event that you do lose power. We always say it every day here at Dominion, we want our employees to go home the same way they come to work, and the same can be said for our customers. Their safety and our employee safety is the utmost concern. Now, just to provide you all with an overview of what we refer to as our power delivery system, which again includes our transmission and distribution system. Within our service territory, which is Virginia, North Carolina, we serve roughly 2.8 million electric distribution customers. And a lot of times I like to tell those that ask, our service territory basically covers the I-95 corridor from DC to Northeast North Carolina, as well as the I-64 corridor from Hampton Roads all the way out to Lexington. And then there's a lot of co-op territory mixed in, but a lot of the major population centers are covered by Dominion Energy. Within the last 10 years, we've had over 400,000 new connects. So as Virginia, North Carolina grow, so does our service territory, and it increases the number of devices and equipment and customers out there that will be impacted by weather systems and restoration events. Within our service territory, there's 58,000 miles of distribution line. Not all of it is overhead, but as you can see, just from the sheer number of miles, that's a lot of area, a lot of miles of distribution line that can be impacted during weather systems. So you have a major weather event come in, it can do a lot of damage. So it's just a lot of geographical area and miles of line that we have to cover and restore. And to a lesser extent, we have 6,600 miles of transmission lines, not necessarily impacted to the extent as distribution lines during weather systems, but major restoration events. Think of your hurricanes, major winter weather events. They also can impact the transmission system. But again, your typical thunderstorm that you experience, you know, on a weekly basis during the summer, not necessarily as big of a risk to the transmission system. Throughout the 58,000 miles of distribution system, we have 580,000 transformers. The transformers are those cylinder-looking devices that you'll see on most poles. Have wires running from them. So a lot of times during lightning storms, those can be impacted. And then again, as you can see right below that, we have 1.1 million distribution poles. And anytime a pole is broken or a pole falls, those transformers are going to be impacted. So as you can see, a lot of equipment out there on the distribution system that is you know, prone to be impacted during restoration events, and that we have to send our crews out and restore and get those back up and operational and replace to get lights on. Within the distribution side of the company, we have the Emergency Preparedness Center. I work in the Emergency Preparedness Center. It's a relatively small team that's comprised of individuals whose primary focus is storm restoration. There's a lot of different groups at Dominion Energy who, on a day-to-day basis, they're not necessarily worried or focused on restoration events or storm events. But it's our job in the Emergency Preparedness Center to make sure that we're at our utmost preparedness when those events do occur. So, like I said, not every group is primarily focused on storm restoration, but when we are impacted, all those groups do have storm roles. So when we go into a restoration event, it's all hands on deck. And the Emergency Preparedness Center is responsible for training all those different groups on their storm roles, making sure that they have the right applications and training to respond when our customers need them the most. We also manage internal and external relationships regarding storm restoration and overall emergency preparedness. So have a close relationship with VDEM, various emergency management agencies throughout the Commonwealth and North Carolina, as well as our local jurisdictional partners to make sure that we're on the same page when the lights go out. Additionally, within our service territory, we have three regional operations centers. We refer to them as ROCs. One's located in Northwest in Herndon, which Fairfax County, which is responsible for Fairfax County and the surrounding areas in Northern Virginia. We have one in the Richmond area and one out in Norfolk for our Eastern and Northeast North Carolina partners. And then again, the Emergency Preparedness Center is overall crisis response for the distribution side of the company. And within the Emergency Preparedness Center, we have a weather team. We have two meteorologists on staff, and their primary focus is forecasting weather, and not just like your traditional meteorologists that you might see on TV. Our meteorologists, they're making forecasts, but they're also looking at weather patterns and models, and they're looking at that information to determine the impact it's going to have on our distribution system. So they're looking at wind speeds, ground saturation, things of that nature to determine the impact that we're going to see from specific weather events. They basically translate weather forecast into outage predictions, and we take that information and really fine tune our planning to make sure that we're at our most prepared prior to a restoration event. So when lights do go out, we can respond in the most efficient, effective way possible. External partnerships, those are critical to our success in storm restoration. The EPC, we're actively involved with VDEM. We're a member of the Virginia Emergency Support Team. We participate in those trainings, and during restoration events, we send a liaison to the state EOC when it's activated to streamline communications between the state, our municipalities that we serve, so we can really fine-tune our restoration and make sure that we're serving our customers in the most efficient and effective way possible. And a lot of times, jurisdictions will reach out to VDEM requesting assistance from Dominion, whether it be road clearing crews, property restoration with certain locations, and they have a point of contact right at the EOC that we can kind of jumpstart that communication. So we're not trying to figure out the right person to contact. We already have that person in the state EOC, and we can really get a jump start on getting lights on. Additionally, all three of our regional operation centers are actively involved in their regional emergency management groups. For Northern Virginia, our Northwest ROC is actively involved in Northern Virginia Emergency Response System. So at the regional level, we're building those key critical relationships to make sure that we're at our most prepared when our customers need us. Year-round preparation. It's a constant 24/7 battle to be prepared. As you can see, in the winter season that we're currently in, we're doing a lot of planning, training. We're going back and looking at our plans, our checklist, kind of our processes to how we respond to restoration events. We're fine-tuning them, making the necessary updates that we've identified from after-action reviews, from exercises, training events, and actual storm restoration. And then as we move into the spring, we do a lot of storm roll training to make sure that our personnel are at their most prepared and trained up on their storm rolls. And then we participate in internal and external exercises. And then moving into summer, that's when you see we always say that it's always storm season, but typically in the summer, you start seeing an uptick in thunderstorms, especially in the months of June and July. And then as summer gives way to fall, that's when we're at our most increased risk of tropical events, especially in Northeast North Carolina, Virginia. Historically, we're most prone to tropical and hurricane impacts late August into early to mid-October. I'm sure a lot of people out there will remember some of our bigger impacts. Hurricane Irene in 2012, it was an August impact. And then Hurricane Isabel 2003, that was a mid-September impact. So we get later into summer and into our peak tropical storm season, that's when we're really focused on making sure that we're at our most prepared and we can respond efficiently if we are impacted by a major restoration event. And now I'm going to go over our restoration process, provide a high-level overview. A lot of times when someone learns that I work at Dominion or we're interacting with our jurisdictional and state partners, they have a lot of questions regarding the restoration process. So hopefully this piece of the presentation will provide those answers. So again, it's a common theme. Our number one restoration tenet is focus on safety. From a day in, day out perspective, we're highly focused on safety. But when it comes to storm restoration, most of the time our crews, they're working in either inclement weather, tough weather conditions, working long hours and out in the elements. So we all start our day during restoration events with a safety stand down, pre-job briefing, and just to make sure that we focus on safety, not just for our employees' sake, but also for our customers. And then also informative communications. If we're not communicating effectively internally and externally, we're not going to be successful during restoration. So we're in constant communication with all our restoration personnel, as well as our jurisdictional partners, our state partners, to make sure that we're all on the same page throughout the restoration process. And each storm is different. So we're constantly assessing the damage and planning and executing a restoration strategy in the way that makes the most sense to get lights on in the safest, quickest, most efficient manner possible. And again, you know, ice storms are different than tropical events, and they all pose their unique challenges. So all of our restoration plans and processes, they're flexible. And for that reason, so no matter what event we find ourselves in, we can get lights on as quickly and safely as possible. So when we are impacted by a major restoration event, and actually when we're forecasting and planning on being impacted, our Emergency Preparedness Center turns into what we refer to as the System Storm Center. And during restoration events, the System Storm Center, it provides the incident command for restoration. Typically, the System Storm Center will only open when it's a multi-region event and it surpasses the level of our regional operations centers and our local offices to respond. So typically we open when it impacts the vast majority of our service territory. So think your major hurricane events, major thunderstorm events, winter storms, ice storms, things like that. So we really coordinate storm restoration at the system level. So when we're moving crews from region to region, bringing all system crews in, we're really driving that to take that burden off of our regional and local offices so they can focus on getting lights on, and we handle the logistics and the manning and the resources and setting that operational plan so that they can handle the physical restoration side of it. And we also oversee all internal communication from an ICS incident command system standpoint. We want that single point of contact from a communication standpoint, so we're speaking on the same message, both internally and externally, so people aren't hearing different messages. And that's critical during restoration events to make sure that we are at our most best to be serving our customers. And then, so the three regional operations centers during a storm, just like the EPC, the Emergency Preparedness Center becomes the System Storm Center. Those three three regional operations centers, those become regional storm centers. And like I just said, they're focused on that regional restoration. They're working with the local offices in their regions. Each region has roughly 10 local offices. The Northwest Regional Operations Center, which oversees operations in Fairfax County. They have offices from Charlottesville up to Arlington and Alexandria. So they have kind of the Northern Virginia geographical area for Dominion Energy Service Territory. And they're coordinating with those local offices, as well as those local jurisdictions and state partners in those areas. They're providing road clearing crews to local jurisdictions to get trees off the roadways so emergency vehicles can get in and do their rescue operations and perform their restoration operations. So we prioritize that. And they're also working with us to bring in necessary resources and materials to get those to the most impacted and affected areas during a restoration event. So I would say the vast majority of time, we know when we're going to be impacted by a major restoration event. So we have a lot of processes and checklists in place so that when we are finally impacted, we're ready to go and get lights on as quickly as possible. And again, it goes back to that daily forecast that our weather team is putting out. And then it's really just, you know, for a lot of Dominion Energy on the distribution side of the company, it's kind of turning their hat around and doing their storm roles instead of their day-to-day roles. So we have those processes in place. And then additionally, if we're forecasting that our internal resources aren't going to be able to meet the demand of work requests, we belong to what's called the Southeast Electric Exchange. And it's a group of all the investor-owned utilities in the Southeast. And we work through them to obtain mutual assistance in the event that we need them. We will bring on other utilities crews, bring them into our service territory, and we'll distribute and allocate those resources to the most impacted areas to help us get lights on. And then additionally, from a planning standpoint, it's constant communication with our stakeholders, from the State Corporation Commission to VDEM to our local partners, working with our media partners, both internally and externally, to just make sure that our customers are getting the information they need from a storm standpoint and a restoration standpoint. And one of the most common questions that we get regarding restoration is, how do you restore power? And this image does a good job of high level, giving you a image view of how we kind of prioritize restoration. Now, I do want to make clear that all this is happening simultaneously. So we're working on the transmission system while we're working on the distribution system and vice versa. We're working on the transmission system and distribution simultaneously, but we have to get the transmission system up and running to get the distribution system fed. And as you can see here, number one, it kind of dictates what the transmission system is. Number two gives you an image of what substations are. Substations distribute power to circuits. And then number three, they're the main circuits. Think of from a VDOT standpoint, the main circuits are your main highways. And then number four would be your residential lines. And those would be your secondary roads. And then once you get into the neighborhoods, you find your individual transformers and service points. Indicated by 5 and 6. Now, also, our communications team, they get this question quite a bit as well. Why does my neighbor have power and I don't? And this image does a great job of depicting that. And it's primarily because there's different service points to that, to you and your neighbor's house. And that's why one may not have power and the other one does. And as you can see here, you can see both the lines fed from 4 and 5. You can see that there's both a tree on the line that feeds one section. The house is on the right. They're all out of lights. And the house is on the left side of the road. They all have power on because that line is still intact. So typically when your neighbor has power or somebody in your neighborhood has power and you don't, it's simply because the line that feeds your service point has been disrupted or a piece of equipment has been damaged on that section. And we're working on getting those lines and damaged equipment fixed as quickly as possible. Again, during restoration events, we go to 24-hour operations. Now, I will say, the vast majority of actual wrench turning and repair work is completed during daylight hours. And that's just simply because it's the most it's the safest for our employees to work in daylight hours, especially when you're working with live wire, electrical equipment. It's obviously safer to work in daylight hours where you can see what you're doing, less electrical hazard risk to our employees. So typically, the vast majority of restoration wrench turning is happening during the daylight hours, but we're also working throughout the night that a lot of times our customers and partners aren't seeing. So just to walk you through a 24-hour restoration overview is our crews normally get into the office between 5 and 6. They'll do their pre-job briefing. And then they'll receive their work packages that have been developed overnight. They'll go out, they'll make their repairs. We also have patrol teams that are driving the circuits or the lines, and they're looking for damage. They're creating, they're associating damages to work request. And then as day turns into night, we have a work packaging team who works overnight. They take all that information that the patrol teams have collected and they create work packages to deliver to the crews that come in the next morning. And then the crews, they'll do it again, pre-job briefing, safety briefing, go out and turn lights or turn wrenches until we get lights on. And we do that until we get all the lights on in our service territory. Now, one thing I do want to note is early on during restoration events, we'll go ahead and turn ETRs off or estimated time of restoration off projects. So when you go in to the outage map, or you call in, you might not get an estimated time of restoration if your power's out. And we simply do this because we don't have enough information early on in a restoration event until we do our damage assessment, until we send our patrol teams out there to manually patrol the lines to collect damages, to provide that information accurately. And we don't want to provide inaccurate information to our customers. So early on during restoration events, please note that you won't see an estimated time of restoration, but as we go through our patrol process, then we'll start turning ETRs on for individual work projects. And lastly, the number one thing that we ask our customers behind being safe and staying away from wire down and down power lines is please report your outage. You have three ways to report your outage. First being you can always call the customer helpline. That's 1-866-DOM-HELP. You can also visit dominionenergy.com and report your outage through our website. And then lastly, over the past couple of years, we've developed a mobile application. And you can download that application and you can manage your account and report your outages through that as well. So it's just a few ways that our customers can report their outages during any major restoration event or if you lose your power on a normal day. So that is the main three ways to report your outage, and we encourage you to do so. There's oftentimes a misconception that, you know, we know when your power's out, and that has improved. And with advanced metering infrastructure, AMI meters, we're getting better at capturing that data, but it's still imperative that our customers call us when they lose power. It helps us create those projects and more efficiently and gives us better situational awareness of what's going on so we can get crews out and to those locations that are experiencing power outages. So, but that's all I have for the presentation. Courtney, I'm gonna turn it back over to you.
Thank you so much. Yeah, all of this is super important. And, you know, we do wanna highlight, we have a great relationship with Dominion. Our duty officers talk to them all the time when we're, you know, experiencing bigger events or even garden apartment fires where we have, you know, no power, and we're working, you know, to get that restored as quickly as possible. So thank you for being such great partners and coming on and giving us a little overview.
Anytime. Thank you for having us.
So just for you guys, we have our social media up on here. I do want to stress that We do post a lot of information regarding weather and potential weather events on social media. We also encourage people to report their outages, as soon as something happens. So you can follow us on Facebook, X, and then we also now have Instagram. So those are some great tools that you can use. We are going to have another webinar coming up in March. We are going to be talking about Flood Awareness Week. So Flood Awareness Week is coming the first week in March. So we'll have guests on from the Department of Public Works and Environmental Services to talk about flooding and how we can do some mitigation efforts to make sure that we're not affected. And that's all we have for you today. But thank you again for joining us, and we look forward to seeing you next time.